Everybody, welcome back. I'm the Strategy Professor, and today we're going to be doing a new playthrough of Darkwood. So special thanks to David G for sponsoring this. If you'd like to sponsor a playthrough of any single player game that you're interested in, just let me know. Email me, strategyprofessor@gmail.com, or you're welcome to come by a stream as well. We stream on YouTube every night starting around midnight Eastern Standard Time, usually go till about 4 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Pretty much stream League of Legends all the time, but I'm happy to talk with you about any other games you might be interested in. Right now, it's just $5 an hour plus the cost of the game, and I can help you crowdsource some funding for that. So if the total bill, you want to see about 20 hours of something, if I already own it or if it's a free game, that'd be $100. But if you want to go 50-50 with someone else, or even, you know, like 33 split between three people, I can help you do that. So just let me know if you're interested. We are doing Darkwood right now. We're also doing a Witcher 3 playthrough. And then I consistently put out a ton of content for League of Legends and for Total War. So come by, check all that out. Okay, let's go ahead and get in here. We're just going to go normal difficulty just because I'm just not super familiar with the game. Usually I like to go the hardest difficulty, but I want to make sure that we can try to get through as much of the story as we can. Because David wanted about 20 episodes. So, okay, let's go ahead and do it. So normal difficulty, don't skip the prologue. Let's do it. So I did a few episodes of this, and then I realized I was doing a lot of kind of stuff wrong. I didn't know what was going on. So I did look up just some preliminary mechanical stuff, like what do certain items build into, watched like how does combat work in some cases and things like that. So I did look up a little bit about the game, but I'm still relatively in the dark about the big story points that go on. So I'm not an expert, but I at least kind of know what's going on so that I'm not just kind of fumbling around, not doing anything for a while. So we can just progress the plot a little bit. So it's still, a lot of it's in the dark, but it's not like fully in the dark in terms of mechanics as far as my experience with the game. Setup and it make for a dark game like this, it can like glare off the screen, so I have like several lights all around me right now to try to give like good lighting, so it'll be a little more shadowy on my face, but whatever, it's fine. Okay, I thought there was a quicker button. Okay. Oh yes, I feel so much better. Okay, you can't run backwards. Yeah, they had run on the shift key, which I really hate stuff that takes like two buttons in general, but it's just really weird on my hand to have to put like my third finger or my pinky finger on the shift key, so I moved it over to the space bar. Oops. There's some gasoline. Thank you. gonna leave that in there and see what happens. I do have to get used to the new keys, because I was kind of getting used to the shift key, but... Wait, did I not take it? Okay. Okay, gotta get used to it. Controls. Did I not take the key? Where? I thought I just took the key. Oh, I have to, okay, yeah. I think I have to hold it down. There we go. Yeah, doggo's not looking good there. Oh, that's interesting. It does tell you in the chat it changed. Button to take aim. Okay, it's the run button. Okay, so... So I would need a bottle for them. I don't think it's gonna matter, though. I need from the torch? Oh, I needed a bottle. Alright. Bottle or gasoline. So I could have had the bottle back from the hideout. I chose not to pick it up for reasons. Spoilery reasons. I don't think it would matter either way, but... So we're like in another house right now. There's like an elk that's been shanked. winter's turning bad. It is kind of brutal, but at the same time, he probably thinks that I'm involved with some kind of conspiracy or something. Like, why? So now you're this guy that you just found. So it heals you slowly over time once you bandage. So you can't just bandage in the middle of a fight and get away from like tough situations. So I can't get any of that stuff. I was thinking maybe if I didn't take the stuff with the doctor initially, that maybe I could get it with somebody else. Certainly doesn't look good. Thank you. See that little bar down at the bottom? That's me filling it up. That should be enough, I think. This is a weird orientation. It's somewhat procedurally generated. Some stuff is where it kind of always is, but... But yeah, like the orientation of the house and some other things are a little bit different. One of our hideouts. Okay, so he's part of some kind of group. So this oven apparently can protect you from some stuff. So you get some weird food, and then it, you turn it into stuff that can power you up here. Makes that kind of weird, funky sound. This is where you can make certain things after you gather stuff. Yeah, here we go. So you can gather these shrooms. Yeah, it gives you 10 essence. I think that's part of the main story progression. Climb through the window here. There's the generator. So it takes about one bar for a night to keep the lights going and some other stuff. Torch, okay. Sometimes there were like, I thought there were more shrooms around here. You gotta be careful because if you accidentally step on the mushrooms and you can't harvest them and they do a little bit of damage to you, oddly enough. Mushroom remains, okay. And you want to try to put them in here as fast as possible because they do decay over time. With these poison mushrooms on the ground. Burned house. Okay, I've never seen this setup before. Gotta be quick, because you only have so much daylight. There's a little stuff going on in there. Destroyed generator, okay. Let's go this way. Pretty good grab there. happened last time too. I had a dog there, so I guess the dog just kind of always appears. Oh god. Cannot fight him, we don't have a weapon. What is the aggro range on these things? See anything else, any other major landmarks. It's a bear trap, so you can dismantle this and get some metal pieces. You do not want to step on those. But yeah, the big stuff, big deal stuff, they will mark on the map. Usually where there are crows, there's a carcass. So there's the house again. Okay, that's gonna be difficult to deal with. He's still coming? Oh my god. Dogs are relentless. Alright. Dude. Get out of here. We can't use the saw yet. Because we don't have any wood logs. I don't know how to get the code to that thing. Okay, so we ran all the way to the right. We still haven't found the logs. Pretty troll. Usually, from what I understand, there's often like a little place with logs. I found one last time. From what I remember, something real spooky comes running out of there. Still coming for me? Where is this? Is this like to the right of the house? Okay, so we don't even necessarily. So we can just put a bunch of this stuff over here. Don't need the lantern right now. Oh my gosh. We gotta catch in these shrooms. Okay, so now we have to pick a bad trait and a good trait. We get to see Eagle Eye. Heal yourself standing next to mushrooms. I don't want to do that. Learn your location on the map. Heal by standing next to an electric light source. Or be able to see further. I think I just want to see further. Two twine. We only have one. It's about to get interesting. I can't find this, the woods. Okay, so there's a crate to the bottom left. We gotta remember that. Don't have any lock picking. Oh, here we go, here we go, here we go. Okay. We got all of them. I think we did. Oh, that one. Let me search that. Don't like that sound. Looks like it's about to get to be dark. Maybe. Yeah, it's definitely looking like dusk. Gasoline to cut this stuff though. Jeez. Where's my gas? Do we not have more fuel than that? Oh, do we have to Like, use the fuel. Go with this, and then didn't need to use that, but I'm getting a little freaked out by these lights here. About to come and you get refilled health and stuff like that, so I was just looking to see if anything else was like if anything had actually come in. Okay, so that was a little awkward because I wanted to, like, you can't really choose how you move this, I don't think. I was gonna try to block this off with it, but I don't think I can do that. I can only use it to, like, block off some stuff. So your reputation is like your, like money with him. Gasoline's pretty nice. I feel like wood is huge. Wood and nails. Kind of what you need for almost everything early on. Does he even sell wood? I guess he doesn't have it. Bottle might be good. The wire for lock picking is probably good. Probably a bunch of these nails. Okay. So I think we can just pretty safely sell him this, like, 9-volt battery. Probably our food. Alcohol's okay. Meds, we might be able to get rid of that. Flare, we can maybe get rid of. Eventually. Actually, let me see what I need to upgrade that, because that's kind of one of the top priorities is upgrading this. It's So what do we need to... We need more wood. Okay, so we need boards and a lot of nails, I think. Because we need that to barricade a lot of the stuff, too. If you dismantle it, you get some stuff back, but you don't get all of it back. Let's go ahead. Small caliber magazine. Wire. I don't remember what wire is used for. I'm pretty sure we'll be able to see him again at some point, so I think we'll just go with that. Early on, it's all about gasoline, wood, and nails, I'm pretty sure. You can repair this well in order to get like one heal per day, I believe. So we need two more, so that means we need 50 fuel, I think. Which is two of these bars worth. Actually, do we have a lockpick? Or if we do or don't, I think we might have a lockpick. Okay, we need a workbench upgrades. Okay, so we can do a bear trap now if we want to, with scrap metal. We can also do gas bottle, single shot pistol, Molotov cocktail, that's pretty good. Why can't we make this? Oh, that's what's available next. Okay. And a lantern, which we already have. Okay, can we do a lockpick? We don't. We need two wire. Okay, so that's what we need wire for, so we should probably get the wire off of him if possible. Okay, let's see if he's still here or not. Okay, he's still here. So we need that. Might need the lantern. Probably don't need flares. Okay. You want to have as light an inventory as you can. And I guess that's where we'll go ahead and end it for this episode, because we are almost at an hour, and I do need to make these episodes about an hour or so. Anyways, thank y'all very much for tuning in. Hopefully you're enjoying this. It does pick up the pace a little bit. It does get pretty interesting, so stay tuned. Special thanks again to David G for sponsoring this. If you'd like to sponsor a campaign yourself, just email me at thestretchprofessor@gmail.com. Otherwise, I'll see you next time. Have a good day.